I love the Nether update. I mean, we've had plenty of great mods over the years that added content to the Nether, but 1.16 was different because Mojang went in with a very specific goal in mind, to make the Nether livable. In the past, the Nether essentially acted like one big dungeon, a skill check that gatekeeps certain resources until you've proven your worth, not somewhere you'd ever want to actually stay. 1.16 changed that, not just by adding a bunch of brand new stuff, but by adding new ways to do existing things. There's wood and stone for basic crafting, animals that you can eat or ride, locals to trade with, and even a way to set your spawn. Instead of just being a glorified dungeon, the Nether now feels like an actual place, somewhere where a particularly determined player could, if so desired, choose to build their base without too much struggle. Which gives me an idea. If Mojang wanted to make it possible to survive in the Nether, then I want to thrive here. Alright, you read the title. I made a datapack that makes me spawn in the Nether instead of the Overworld at the start of the game. And if I die without setting my spawn, I also respawn in the Nether. Oh, and if I try to use a Nether portal... To be clear, this is not a challenge run, although it will be challenging, and it's definitely not a speed run. There is no win condition here. This is just a survival Minecraft journey, and the only way to start is to throw on the datapack and see where we end up.
All right.
The first thing I do after spawning in is get chased by piglins. So while I'm busy with that, here's how this is gonna go. The Netherstart journey begins the exact same way every Minecraft journey does. Bunch trees to get wood. But whoops, I spawned in the Nether Wastes with a Soul Sand Valley and a Basalt Deltas nearby, and it turns out I just listed every biome except the ones that have trees. I'll need to find one of the forest biomes, but until that happens, I'm going to be stuck in the Nether with no tools and an empty inventory. Which brings us to problem number one of living in the Nether, travel. There are monsters everywhere, the ocean is full of lava for some reason, and the terrain generation isn't exactly pedestrian friendly. This never stops being a challenge, but it's particularly bad when you have no tools for digging tunnels and no blocks for building bridges. First, I check out this little corner of Basalt Deltas, but I die in lava almost immediately and it looks like a dead end anyway. Then this happens.
The Soul Sand Valley is a dangerous place to be. Oh, okay.
So I try following this low-lying area, but I just hit another dead end. Literally. I try the Soul Sand Valley, but I just get jump-scared by a skeleton.
He's right there. Not a problem. Nope.
But then I try a slightly different route. Ignoring the place I just died because it was just another dead end, I head a different direction in the Soul Sand Valley, hoping to find a friendlier way forward. Of course, this is the Nether, so instead I just find a bunch of jagged cliffs. Fortunately, Soul Sand can be collected without any tools, so I grabbed some from the ground to build my way to the next safe area.
Another fortress. Look, that's great. I'm gonna make great use of these in the future. But I'm not in the future yet. I'm in the now, and in the now, what I need is some wood. I'd rather take the high road here, but... It takes me past a ghastness. Oh, never mind. Takes me past just a skeleton. No ghast anymore. Oh boy! No! Another goddamn fortress. I just need a forest. It kinda sounds like fortress. So yeah, I'm like dead. Why do I delude myself? These mushrooms would be better left for future DK. If I find a forest, maybe I can think. That's a forest. Unfortunately, I also found a skeleton.
So I did manage to find a crimson forest, but I also managed to turn myself into a dead corpse, and I don't have faith it'll be any different the second time around. But hey, did you notice that fortress right next to spawn? Yeah, I'd been ignoring it up to this point, but in an act of desperation, I decided to take a look and see if I could find anything useful.
Alright. Oh, shit, why don't I just do it myself?
Yeah, I don't know what I expected. Now, it might seem like I'm completely out of options at this point, but I actually had one more idea. See, I had a feeling there might be a way forward on top of this big cliff. If I could just reach the top of it.
Had to happen eventually. You're not gonna believe it. There's nothing up here.
Okay, so it didn't end up going in the direction I was hoping for. Instead, it took me through a small cave area to this high road overlooking the fortress from above. And when I followed this path...
The promised land. And there's a couple trees here. Oh shit, there is a hogwin. I think baby hogwins are still aggressive, aren't they? Yep, they are. They are. They're aggressive. Okay. Check this out. Oh my god. Oh my god. Soup.
So I finally have wooden tools, and it only took me 26 minutes. At this rate, I'll have full netherite within the decade.
Oh. You gotta be fucking kidding me. Really? Really, dude? That is so fucking mean! There isn't such a tiny space and you're doing this!
Okay, so it might have taken a while to get here, but now I can finally start mining gold. I grabbed all the gold I could from the area, and grabbed some more mushrooms at the same time, and eventually I was able to afford a pair of golden boots.
I now have boots. Look at me! Look at me with my little boots!
After a bit more mining, I was able to try a bit of piglin bartering, which went,
Okay, he gave me gravel. Which isn't great. More gravel. It's not great, but I will accept it. Because you know what? Gravel isn't super common in the Nether. Spectral arrows, that's technically very good.
Okay, so not the strongest start, but there's a lot more bartering to come. Bartering is going to be absolutely essential going forward, which is all thanks to problem number two of living in the Nether, resources. There's obviously a ton of things that are completely unobtainable in the Nether, like redstone, enchanting tables, and even cobblestone. But even the things that do still exist here tend to be pretty hard to come by. Iron is almost as rare as diamonds here, and diamonds are already rarer than usual. Piglin bartering is probably the best source of iron, because piglins have a 2% chance of offering between 10 and 36 iron nuggets in exchange for a gold ingot. On average, it takes 40 nether gold ore blocks to fund just a single iron nugget. So yeah, we're gonna be sticking with stone tools for a while. Speaking of which, I got a hold of some stone tools in that little corner of Basalt Delta from earlier. I grabbed a bunch of extra blackstone for good measure, because stone tools aren't exactly known for their durability. On the way back to spawn, I mined a lot more gold, so I was able to do some more bartering. I got a lot of junk, but also some useful stuff. More blackstone, crying obsidian, leather, string, spectral arrows. Oh, and this.
I've got a deal for you. I get trade offer. I give you 12 gold. You give me, I don't know, water bottle. Keeping that for later.
As you can probably guess, water is kind of a precious resource in the Nether, so this is actually one of the best possible items a Piglin can give. Finally, it's time to start working on my starter base. I started with a blackstone foundation and used crimson planks for the walls. I felt like this little hut deserved to look like an overgrown mushroom, which is why I went for a circular floor plan. I was originally going to use a mixture of nether block and netherrack for the roof, but it didn't end up looking too great, so I returned to the Crimson Forest to get some more nether warp blocks. They're surprisingly slow to mine even with a stone hoe, which is not fun, but I'm just going to have to get used to that. Oh, and on the way home I also died fighting a ghast. That's neither here nor there. After getting my items back, I got back to work on the roof. I can't say I've ever used nether warp blocks in a build before, which is pretty surprising since they've been in the game for quite a long time now. No expense spared on the underside of the roof either. I didn't have a lot of weeping vines on me, but I'll be able to spread them around over time since these ones will just keep growing. And with a shroom light, this place is actually starting to feel cozy. I went for a slab floor, mostly for looks, but also to prevent spawning since light level doesn't affect most nether mobs. You can also see me trying to make a crude approximation of a bed, since we can't have a real one. This interior is going to change quite a bit later, but this is a nice start for now. And with my starter base more or less complete, I decided it was time to end the first recording. The first thing I noticed on starting the second recording was that the zombie piglins had an interesting new fashion choice.
Right. It's Halloween today.
Yeah, so now you know how long it took me to edit this. More importantly, I had a plan for this recording. To finally explore that Nether Fortress. We've basically got the best tools we'll ever have, so why not give it a try?
I don't know if we need this. Well, not my problem as long as I don't go over there. This spawner, I feel, is just gonna be an inconvenience to me. Right back to where we started, by the way. Yeah, that's what I expected. All these blind corners are extremely unsettling. I mean, a saddle. Wait, holy shit, I was like, oh, that's not anything special. No, a saddle, though. That's actually something we really fucking needed. Okay. There we go. There's the jackpot. Oh, shit. Yep. Okay. Yeah, you know what? I'm just gonna... Oh. Hey, gentlemen. Oh god. Here I go. I didn't realize I was on such low HP. Oh! Hi. Yeah? Ooh, that was nice. Okay, that's what spectral arrows are good for.
So what did I get in all that? Well, I got some gold and nether wart, which are both handy. The saddle is a pretty big find, too. The best reward, though, is obviously the iron and diamonds. Three of each, that's a pretty big haul. And even the horse armor is useful because...
we can actually smelt this stuff up. So it's not useless.
Yep, iron is so valuable, I'm melting down horse armor to get just a few extra nuggets. If only I could do the same for diamond horse armor. Oh, and also, there might be a teensy little problem.
Oh.
Yeah, I ran out of brown mushrooms. Given that this is kind of my only food source, that isn't exactly an ideal situation to be in. I went out to get more and eventually found a much larger Crimson Forest area just around the corner from the first one. And yeah, I found some more brown mushrooms there, and I also managed to do a bit of hoglin hunting.
Certified hoglin woman.
And that's all great, but it doesn't solve the root of the issue. Along the way, I'd been doing some thinking about problem number three of living in the Nether, food. See, acquiring food in the overworld is inherently agrarian. You're a farmer from the start, growing crops and breeding animals for your dinner. Eventually, you can also industrialize your farms to save yourself time in the long run. But in the Nether, you start as a hunter-gatherer, hunting hoglins and gathering mushrooms. And as any Paleolithic human could tell you, a hunter-gatherer cannot survive in a sedentary lifestyle. I'm just gonna keep running out of food as long as I stay in one place, and being a nomad doesn't seem ideal in the building game. So if the long-term goal in the overworld is industry, the long-term goal in the Nether is agriculture. And it's for this reason that I started to think about mushroom farming.
Goddamn mushroom farming? It's been years since I've heard anyone talk about farming mushrooms.
Now you can hear that I don't sound super excited, and that's mainly because I was thinking of the slow way of farming mushrooms, where you wait for them to spread naturally. But there is a faster way, and I was surprised to learn that it's actually possible in Nether.
Mushrooms plant on the appropriate block. Yeah, I don't think we can make giant mushrooms here. Yeah. Oh, on Nylium blocks. Oh wait, no, we can't. Okay. Oh shit. Soup is totally sustainable.
And so, armed with some bone meal I stole from the Soul Sand Valley, it was time for an agricultural revolution. Have you ever had to cut down trees for your lunch in vanilla Minecraft before? I certainly haven't, but it's not that bad. Well, except for all the axe durability it uses. This is going to be my main food source for a long time, since hoglin breeding has a few major hurdles to overcome that make it absolutely impractical for the time being. Not that I'm complaining. It feels great to finally have a use for mushroom stew. Until I can get some Nylium at my house, I'm gonna have to come out to the forest every time I want to get some more food. At least it's a pleasant walk. Okay, so let's take stock of where we're at. So far, I've crawled my way to a forest to get wood for tools and soup, mined blackstone to upgrade to stone tools, built a basic starter base, raided another fortress, and established a sustainable food source in the form of endless soup. All of this, and I still haven't even mentioned a certain other feature of my Netherstart datapack.
I may have created a few custom advancements. These are not win conditions. There is no win condition. These are long-term goals to give me a sense of direction.
And those goals are? Listen to Pigstep, brew a night vision potion, obtain any piece of enchanted netherite equipment, and create this banner. Yep. As you can probably guess, these are some of the hardest things you can do in this scenario. And somehow the one I'm most worried about isn't the enchanted netherite, it's that banner. If it doesn't sound so bad, try and think about how we're gonna get the dye. Yeah. Will I ever finish these goals? I don't know. For now, these are just gonna be the albatross around my neck. Anyways, hey, did you notice I've been kinda clear-cutting this grove in the background? I mined a bunch more blackstone on the way home, too. While you've been distracted by my fancy datapack nonsense, I've been gathering material to do some more building. Come on, you didn't think I was gonna leave my starter base looking like that, did you? From the moment I built it, I knew this little hut needed a tower. I started by marking out another blackstone circle overlapping the first one, and then I got right to building up the walls. The height of the tower was decided entirely by how high it needed to be to keep the roof separate. I knew right away the shapes involved with this build would absolutely cause headaches with the interior, so I just decided to wing it. At this point, I got distracted by the highly unnerving lava fall next to the build site, so I decided to clean it up a bit. Moving on to the interior for now, I tried my best to wrangle this floor plan into something that looked marginally okay. Moving windows and doors, adjusting corners, it's all a part of the process. you can see that working out the ceilings was a bit of a struggle. Not very easy to connect the inside of the lower roof to the wall of the tower, and I definitely didn't want to divide the two halves of this floor with a wall. At this point, I started working on the staircase. I wanted a slab staircase to spiral up along the walls, which isn't the easiest at this scale. You can see me going through a handful of iterations here, mostly focusing on how to handle the corners. Instead of an entire second floor, which wouldn't have played well with the staircase, I went for more of a loft design. You can see that missing slab there, entirely a result of me running out of nether bricks. It'll get fixed up soon. At this point, I'm just switching out the bottom slabs for top slabs so I can have a fenced railing along the edge. I needed to move my chest so I could build a hearth, but a piglin overheard and chose to decapitate me for the crime of redecorating. After sorting that out, I started working on the fireplace, but I ran out of nether bricks again, so I got more from the nether fortress. I don't know why a house in the nether would need a hearth, but it definitely does make it objectively cozier and is therefore a compulsory element of the build. After adding the chimney, I threw in a little garden of nether ward outside the entrance. I think it does a great job of visually rooting the build in the ground. And after some finishing touches, it's time for a tour.
Alright, so this is what we got. Got a lovely little place, added a whole extra module that is way taller. This is a starter house I can be proud of. Inside, got my chests where I can store all of my lovely, lovely valuables, including all the nether bricks I collected to make that staircase. Spiral staircase, also this.
This is just a resource pack I made ages ago that changes how tools and weapons look when they're in item frames. Great for decorative touches like this.
Go up the stairs. Got some storage up here. And another light. I'm quite happy with it. Also, fireplace. Got my furnace, and then I got a lovely little soul campfire, which would be great for cooking hoglin meat. Just a beautiful little build, I think.
And hey, with my starter base finished for real this time, I promise, that marks the end of the first chapter in my Netherstart journey. Hey, thanks for watching! I've been wanting to do this for a really long time, so I hope you enjoyed watching it as much as I enjoyed making it. This did take me a month to edit, so future episodes will probably be a bit less highly edited. That said, don't expect the next one to come quickly. I think I'm supposed to say an outro here, but I've never been very good at those, so I'll just let you listen to the Kirby music.